This recording is protected by copyright. No part may be reproduced without the prior permission of the University of South Australia.
Good day, I'm John Wilkinson, Associate Head of School of Marketing, and we'll be having a presentation from Catherine Andrukovic shortly as well. For those of you who are our real audience, the potential students, not the parents, she'll be more interesting. I think we always have to legally tell you about emergency exit stuff, so if you can take a second and read that. I think if we do have a fire alarm go off here, we're meant to go down to the building next door, the library building, where our booths are. I think that's actually a legal requirement. Okay, we're talking about just one of our 3 degrees in marketing. So some of you may have been to a presentation earlier by Cole Driesner, our program director this year of all our degrees, normally just of 2 of them, about the straight marketing degree. This degree, the Bachelor of Marketing and Communication, is different to our other degrees in that it's a joint degree between this school and the communication school. That is a longer name. But it's put into just 3 years, so it's not like a double degree, which is typically 4 years. So roughly half of the normal business stuff is out of it, half the communication stuff is out of it. Very focused, therefore, on mainly marketing on the business side and communication courses that really help people, if they're doing a marketing degree, learn much more about the creative side of communication. So it's a bit different. It's also quite new. I'm aware of only one other degree like this, not exactly the same, but similar, in Australia, and that's in one of the Perth universities. I'll cover some other stuff more formally in a moment, but this is the degree you should be doing if you want to be on the creative side of marketing. So if you want to get involved in briefing ad agencies, get involved in the communication, whether it's with social media or traditional media, this is the degree. I suppose it's also the degree that you would consider doing if you want to avoid something like economics. You will still have to do accounting in this degree, but you won't have to do economics. If you really want to be a traditional brand manager, eventually becoming a marketing manager, traditional marketer, then the other degree, the straight Bachelor of Marketing, Bachelor of Management, bracket marketing, the DBMK, that's the degree for you rather than this. And if you want to get involved in international marketing, then after this session you should go to, I think it's HH308, but there's a slide here, where Carl Driesner will be talking about double degrees in general, but using our double degree with international relations to illustrate. And that's the one that you should do if you really want to get involved in overseas stuff. Still marketing, but in the international arena. So a couple of quick video clips. And if you've seen these in the DBMK, hopefully you'll find them interesting a second time around. Oops, that didn't work, did it? No. Apologies, I probably should put my glasses on.
Hello, I'm a Mac.
Hold up, here I come.
Whoa, PC?
Yeah, it's all this trial software. They pack my hard drive full of it, all these programs that don't do very much unless you buy the whole thing, or just plain useless. Oh, it really slows me down. You know how it is.
Oh, actually, I don't. That's just come with the stuff you want, like iTunes, iMovie, iPhoto, iWeb. It's all part of iLife.
Yeah, yeah. Are you ready? Let's just do this, okay?
Okay. Hello, I'm Mac.
I forgot something.
Besides the fact that our school is mainly a Mac school, which is why some of my colleagues really like that ad, and in fact, it's quite a funny ad, I guess, although some of us who feel we should lose weight might not find it that funny. I guess one of the things about our degrees is that you would learn why that is or isn't, we think it is, a good ad, rather than just saying, hey, it's funny, knowing something more about why perhaps it will be an effective ad. Likewise, this, which is a very different type of ad, although still using humor, would also be perhaps quite a good ad.
Mike, come on!
Mike, what is your deal,
man? Oh, come on, man. You've been riding me all day.
Mike, you're playing like Betty White out there.
That's not what your girlfriend said.
Oh, baby!
Whoa.
Eat a Snickers. Better? I'm on bed.
That hurt.
You're not you when you're hungry. Snickers satisfied.
So particularly with this particular program you're talking about, the marketing and communication degree, you would learn a lot about what's done behind the scenes to make an ad like that. You'll also learn about the market research that might support this type of ad being effective, as well as the earlier one. And then if we're aiming at a much different audience, there might be a very different approach to the advertising. And obviously, some of the people who would graduate from this degree might eventually be in jobs where they would be briefing an ad agency about what the message should be, and even perhaps about the need for humor or not in the ad, and getting very much involved in developing ads, including ads like this. As I said before, we have these two specializations in 3 years, so it's a joint degree, not a double degree. You may hear about double degrees, and they do take longer, obviously, than a single degree. And as I said before, it's really for people who want to be involved in the creative side of marketing rather than the mainstream brand management side. Although should you change your mind partway through the degree, you certainly can finish this degree and look for brand management jobs. That's not a problem, but it's particularly relevant in the creative side. So some reasons why we think if you want to do a marketing degree, particularly focus on the creative side, why this is the place to do it. Can you read that at the back, by the way? Okay, so I won't read all this for you. I will speak a bit more about the Ehrenberg-Bass Institute. Institutes, in case you don't know, inside a university, mean that, first of all, to use the word institute, we have to be accredited by a body that includes overseas people, external university, but including some overseas people. We can't just call ourselves the Ehrenberg-Bass Institute. To use the word institute, we have to have that formal accreditation process. So just the fact that we have an institute attached to our school means that some external body has looked at us and believes that we do things that are of an international standard. The names, by the way, are of two people, both now deceased, but who we believe put the science into marketing. And we do have a very scientific approach to our research. And I'll pick that up shortly. Like all 3-year degree programs in this university, we do 24 courses in those 3 years. So a full-time load would be 8 courses per year. You may think of courses as subjects. We call them courses, degrees, programs. So if you were full-time, you'd tend to do 4 courses each study period, the 2 study periods a year, and you finish in 3 years. And obviously, you can do it part-time. You can take twice as long or something different. You can actually do things a little bit faster because we do occasionally offer courses in summer, not many, but some. So occasionally, you can do things a little faster. For top students, obviously, you can also go on to honors if you wish, or do something else like a master's by research, or go on and do a PhD if you want to become an academic or a highly qualified researcher. And you can obviously study on campus or online or a mix of those. So we do have all of our courses, not quite all of the McGill courses yet, but all of the marketing and business courses, and most of the McGill courses, the communication side, are available externally as well. Some of the courses you will do, this is just 7 or 8 of the 24, but just gives you an idea. So things like advertising are done here by our school, whereas public relations and some of these other courses are done by the people from McGill, although some of those courses are taught on this campus. So some of the classes you do will be done at McGill. They're not all done on this campus yet. We also have quite a strong focus, besides taking the results of our research on the marketing side and putting those into our course content, we do also try to have a very strong experiential focus. So we try to bring in the experience that some of us have. So in terms of teaching staff, some are older like myself, having worked in industry first, whereas there are some people not much older than Catherine who are perhaps higher degree research students with us, so they are much closer to the students, having just finished their degrees recently, perhaps doing some research now in the particular area in which they teach, maybe as a tutor. So we have quite a mix of people. Some will bring in experience that is more conventional, some will bring in much more recent experience. And again, for high achieving students, we do invite students to what we call master classes, where we take some issues somewhat further. Two courses that are capstone. One is the marketing course, where in essence students run a company, a car company, in groups of four or five, and they run against four or five competitive groups, making marketing and some other business decisions over their semester. Gives them the opportunity to use all of the theory they've covered so far in real decision making. Admittedly, it's in a simulated environment, but it is also competitive. And that is something which really helps students understand some of the difficulties in the real world. And there's also a capstone course on the other side, taught by the McGill staff as well, which tries to bring in everything. In fact, this course here tries to bring in everything from the communication and marketing sides of the program. We also have experiential learning embedded in this program in a different way. There is a practicum that that is done either as a communication practicum or as a marketing practicum. Students have to either do the communication practicum or they need to apply in a competitive way to do the marketing project, as we call it, from next year. We don't have more than 20 students doing our marketing project per year, so the entry to that is competitive. So the majority of students will, in fact, do the communication practicum, which is done over two semesters, the theoretical side done first, and then the internship practicum, whatever, is done the second semester usually. So again, people have the opportunity to experience what happens in the real world rather than just learning about things from someone in a classroom. Byron Sharp is the director of Ehrenberg Bass Institute. These are some of the things that we focus on. We talk about millions of dollars having been invested to tackle big marketing questions. In fact, Mars, with us, spent a couple of million dollars over the last 3 years. There was another contributor as well to the project. But these are some of the questions, the sort of questions that they actually asked us. Actually, the simplest question with a complicated answer, though, was, why does someone in a supermarket choose this brand off the shelf? Very simple question, complicated answer. But we've done a lot of work for them. Literally, the first round was a $1.75 million project. So again, you can see that some real companies, and this is Mars International, not just Mars Australia, do spend money with us because they believe we do research which is worth having done. Some other companies that are involved, we have about 60-odd companies around the world. In fact, most are overseas, European or American. They pay us money to do research that we think is worth doing, and they get some reports from us in return. Mars being a bit different because they have spent, in fact, a whole lot more money on very customized research for them. Of course, this has benefits for students. It means things that we learn from our research, as well as some commercial market research we do here in Adelaide and across Australia, gets put into our marketing courses. So our courses tend to have things in them which aren't yet in textbooks. And really, you, as students, you would have some of the people teaching you being the same people who maybe have talked just recently with some senior people from some very large companies around the world. Can I get into the program? These are the cutoff scores from last year. One thing that we're doing differently this year as a division, not just as a school, is that if you get a score of 75 or more, you're guaranteed to get in. So it doesn't matter how many people apply. If you've got a score of 75 for any one of our programs in the whole division, not just this program, you will get your top preference from us, irrespective of numbers applying. Commitment. This is something we tend to say across the division, not just within our school, not just this program. So we tend to say if there are four courses, you will have 3 hours of contact per course per week. We think you should be doing something like roughly 10 hours per week in total per course, 40 hours per week. I'm not sure how many people do that. I suspect some students do a whole lot less and get away with it, and some do a whole lot less and perhaps don't get away with it. But this is kind of like what we think you need to do. 2 hours of your own time, whether it's preparation for lectures, preparation for tutorials, reading, assessment, etc. You tend to have 3 hours of contact time. We're suggesting another 9 hours per week. But we know people do a lot less and can still get through things. Although some people do more, but it's your choice, obviously. But the commitment is something like a full-time week if you're studying full-time. The sorts of roles, I would say that really the media manager, advertising type people, public relations in that area, communications manager are the particular areas for this degree, although brand management, product management, and obviously later marketing management generally are also options as well. So something about one of our graduates. And what is interesting about this example perhaps is that she currently works not for a business. So it's important to recognize that employment could be in business, government, or in a whole range of non-government organizations, particularly in this area. Because quite a few organizations, even small organizations, like some of the charities here in South Australia, might not necessarily have someone who's equivalent to a brand manager, but they probably have someone who is doing promotional type work. So this degree is specifically for those type of roles as well. Looking ahead on the 11th of September, there is another session. So if you're interested, you can certainly come along to this. You can either register today. There should be forms around here, particularly next door in the area where the booths are for our programs. But it's also available online to register or to get more details. Two program directors for this program, one being based in our school, Carl Driesner. One being based in the School of Communication, International Studies, and Languages. It's a long name now. But she's based, Jackie Cook is based at McGill. Straight after the session in HH308, if you do want to listen to Carl Driesner talking about double degrees, including specifically our double degree with international relations, it follows this. Just a very quick comment we like to make about why go into marketing before we have Catherine.
Study marketing at UniSA.
And by the way, some of our top students can get involved in some of the commercial market research we do, so they can get some statistical knowledge, plus some market research knowledge. And some of our people in their honors years, for example, and master's years, do get to do some of that travel. We've had some people doing their PhD, for example, get involved in briefing companies like Coke overseas as part of our research program. Catherine. So you have up to 10 minutes if you wish.
My name's Catherine Andrikovic and I studied the Marketing and Communication degree here. I'm currently working at SA Lotteries in marketing, so I thought I'd come here today and talk to you about my experience. It was not so long ago that I was in your shoes and I was about to finish school and I had no idea what I wanted to do, so I thought I'll share my experience and hopefully give you a bit of guidance and help you out with your decision. Okay, so I came to an open day like you about 4 years ago and with a different options for marketing, it does get a bit confusing, but I guess what drew me to this degree was firstly that it was only 3 years. I mean, that was appealing to me because I kind of wanted to get straight into industry when I could. And also I was really interested in advertising, so the communication side of this degree also influenced my decision. I started off in the management marketing degree, and then after 6 months, this degree was quite a new degree and I transferred over. That's the great thing about UniSA is that they make it really easy for you to transfer between the three different degrees. So when I started the marketing communication, I guess the Ehrenberg-Bass Institute was also a big decision in that, was that I would take learnings from their direct research, as John mentioned, with big brands like Mars and Unilever, which was great. So one of the highlights of my degrees was in January of 2010, I was awarded a scholarship to go to San Francisco, and I studied, I didn't study over there, I worked over there, so I did an internship at the Fairmont Hotel in San Francisco for 6 weeks, and it was definitely the highlight of my degree. I've always been a big traveller, as I'm sure a lot of you are or want to be, so that was definitely one thing I wanted to do, and UniSA are great in that they give you opportunities to travel, whether it be studying overseas or working, so I definitely recommend doing something like that. So I also worked at two other places when I was there, so I really, really took the most I could out of that opportunity. And one of those companies was a market research company as well, so it provided me with experience in a different kind of industry again. And then when I came back from there, I was offered a week work experience with them in Sydney, and they were doing a rebranding project for Star City Casino in Sydney, so I was able to work with them on that as well. So I guess, yeah, the point of that is that you just don't know what opportunities can come out of studying a degree and getting opportunities, so you've just really got to put yourself out there, and you know, you never know what you can do. I know when I started, I never thought I'd be going overseas and having an opportunity like that, so UniSA great in getting you involved with those opportunities. During my final year at UniSA, so when I came back from my internship and kept studying, I was also offered a marketing assistant role here at uni with the Ehrenberg-Bass Institute. So I worked part-time during my degree, and that was excellent as well, because I was learning firsthand through the Ehrenberg-Bass Institute as well as studying here. So that was great. Now, I also completed, as John mentioned, the communication practicum. So this enables students to work in industry in the last year of their degree. So you can either choose the communication practicum or the marketing project. So I chose the communication practicum, and I was able to work 1 day a week at a local events company called Cato Events. And yeah, it was great. I just got hands-on experience through my degree, so I was able to take what I was learning in the classroom through to, you know, a real job and real events, and that was great. So definitely, that was a highlight of studying this degree, was being able to get that hands-on experience. So now, what I'm doing now is working at SA Lotteries. So I started off in January of this year, and I started off as a marketing trainee. They only offer that position to UniSA students who study a marketing degree. So that was also a great opportunity. I've been there for 6 months, and I recently got promoted to marketing coordinator, and that was a really excellent opportunity for me. And my job incorporates both the disciplines. So not only do I do marketing work there, but I also work, like John said, with creative agencies and media agencies, and I give them briefs. So, for example, I recently worked on a 20 million mega draw. I don't know if any of you are lotto goers, but you should get your tickets if you want. But yeah, the 20 million mega draw. So I would, for example, I would write a brief and I would call in the agency. So we use Clemenger BBDO. I don't know if any of you know of them. And MEC, which are a global media agency. And we would write a brief. We'd sit them down and we'd discuss the brief and say what our key message what we want our key message to be, who our target audience are, and we do that through market research, which you'll also learn through your degree. And then they'll take that away and they'll come up with a campaign for us that we roll out across all forms of media. So that can include radio, TV, press, we do PR work. So yeah, I've definitely utilised both parts of this degree, both marketing and communications, in my job now. And I think that's the highlight for me, is knowing that what I learnt at uni is transforming into my job now. Because I know you hear a lot of people saying, oh, but I studied this at uni, but I've done a completely different thing, and I don't know how my uni degree has helped me. Sometimes, you know, people can feel like that way, but the marketing communications degree, and specifically what it's given me here in that practical experience, has really helped me to get where I am today. So I definitely, my key tips, I guess, for you guys would be, well, firstly to, you know, it's great that you're coming along to these days and getting as much information as you can to make your decision. But yeah, I would, once you start studying and whatever you choose to do, I would definitely try and get as much practical experience as you can. So whether that be through doing work experience, through talking to your lecturers and trying to get, you know, get networking and get to events to meet people in the corporate world so that, you know, you can have those contacts to use and have work experience. I would also try and go to a lot of the events that UniSA holds. So you'll hear a lot through, you know, your lecturers and your course advisors about different events that are on so that you can do some networking. I'd also definitely go, and I know that there's a booth today in the library about international opportunities, so you can go and study overseas, and that is part of your degree, so that's great as well. And if you have any questions for me at all, just come and ask, and I'll tell you a bit more about how I got to where I am and how the degree helped me get here. So, yeah, I would definitely recommend the course, and I wish you the best of luck in your future. Thank you.
We're nearly done, but we do have time for questions if you want to.